Hello and welcome. Well, it was a good quarter for Crompton Greaves Consumer Electricals as the company posted all-round growth in its first quarter for FY19. Joining us to go over the company's financials is the Managing Director, Shantanu Khosla. Mr. Khosla, thank you for joining us right now. Let me start by asking you about the low base that we've seen that has also aided this company's growth for this particular quarter. Can you tell us a little more about the other factors that have actually led to this growth going forward and what we can expect when it comes to the rest of this financial year?
Of course. Our total business, if you adjust for the GST accounting, grew a healthy 20% for the quarter. If you look at it segment by segment, the key driver of the growth was actually our core ECD, electric consumer durables business, which grew at about 24%. This was driven by really two things. One, the fans business. In the fans business, we had a really wonderful new fan launch, what we call Crompton A360, which is an innovative fan which delivers twice the coverage of a normal fan. And this has helped the growth on fans. In fact, the mid-premium segment where A360 plays grew about 31%. So that innovation in fans, just like anti-dust in the previous year, has been a key driver of fans. The second key driver was also really behind innovation, but this time in our pumps business, where we introduced a new value proposition called Crest Mini. And this helped drive our pump business by, in volume terms, by in excess of 30%, leading also to very strong double-digit value growth in pumps. In lighting, the key driver of growth was our core LED business, which now constitutes about 78% of our total lighting business. For the last few years, we have been single-mindedly focused on driving LED, even though that means that conventional will rapidly decay. Last quarter, our LED lighting business grew by a little more than 40%.
And have you witnessed inflation input costs? What's the outlook on this possible impact on margins going ahead?
Yeah, we've laid out our goals very clearly. You know, we want to grow our top line faster than the market, grow market share, which we've done this quarter. And on margins, we want to make sure that our profits grow at least as fast as top line, which means at the very least hold, if not grow, margins. In the past few quarters, including this quarter, we've actually grown margin. Now, commodity price pressure does exist. In fact, commodities are turning around and they are becoming more expensive. That being said, we've got a very long-term strategic approach to addressing this. Basically, there are three types of actions, and we plan and have covered commodity, one-third of commodity costs with each action. The first is ongoing cost reduction. This is expected to cover one-third of ongoing commodity inflation. The second is continuing to drive mix. And for example, in the previous quarter, we've been extremely successful on doing that in fans by moving people from mid-low tier up to mid-premium tier with the A360 launch, and our value growth is significantly ahead of our volume growth. And the third one-third of commodity coverage comes from price. So you pass on one-third to the consumer, and we believe our brand and our quality is absolutely strong enough to take that price. So this is the way we've been approaching commodities for the past, and we'll continue to do so in the future. Therefore, even though pressures do come, like they did this quarter, we hope to continue to drive top-line growth and gain market share while not losing on margin.
And so will FY19 be more about consolidation in the markets Crompton is already present in, or will the management look to expand, or will it be a mix of both?
Absolutely. First, of course, it does start with driving where we are right now. That is fans, pumps, and lights. Lights is a great example. 3 years ago, we really were a small nothing player. Today, we're the number two lighting player in the country. So we have to keep driving what we call the core. And we see significant upside opportunity there in both premiumization and in driving distribution and reach. In terms of new focus areas, the next two critical two focus areas are in the coolers and geysers business, where we also plan to innovate. We have innovations in the pipeline, so they're not just Me Too products, but they're actually superior consumer preferred products, which we invest behind both in terms of advertising and also distribution. We made a start this season in a small way in coolers, where we're piloting a wonderful innovation called Tri-Cool, which actually cools 60% more than normal coolers. And we're seeing some positive results. In fact, though our business is still currently small, our cooler business, in spite of a market declining market over the previous summer, grew 20%. And the next key focus area to drive incremental growth is for us is geysers.
And finally, sir, I understand that you won't give us a guidance, but can you at least give us an indication when it comes to growth and margins in FY19?
Well, we must remember that to some extent, growth, not just for us, but for all industries in this quarter, does reflect the fact that the previous year had a relatively lower base, because that was the GST transition quarter last year. Now, moving forward, our objective, as we've mentioned before, is very clear. Grow faster than the market, grow market share, and make sure that our margins grow at least as fast. So whatever assumptions anyone takes on market growth, add some growth points to it, and that's our objective.
All right, Mr. Khosla, we'll leave it at that. Thank you so much for joining us and taking you through the quarter's numbers as well as the outlook for the company going in.